What's up, fellas? My name is Ben, and I'm bringing you a 9-part FPS boosting guide. This is the ultimate FPS boosting guide V2. I've worked very hard on this for you guys, and I hope this will fix most of your FPS issues. Before we get started in the series, I will not be held liable for any damage done to your computer or computer hardware. Everything in this guide can be done safely as long as you follow instructions properly. Also, if you would like to view or print out the script of this video, there's a link in the description. This guide will be covering various programs to improve your FPS. If you're gaming on a laptop, don't expect to be getting the same FPS as a custom-built desktop. Feel free to sit back and relax or take some notes while you watch. As a recap, FPS stands for frames per second. Typically, 60 FPS is great, but sometimes the game lags. And anywhere above 30 FPS is good, but still not the best. And having under 30 FPS is sometimes unbearable. So if you're in any of these situations, I'm here to help. If you're unsure what FPS you are getting, you can download a software called Heaven, and there's a link to it in the description. This program can measure how your computer is performing based on certain settings. It will give you a minimum, maximum, and average FPS. After you have downloaded it, start the program. You should leave most of the settings alone, but change the quality to what you think your computer might be able to handle. If this is too much, set the quality lower. For best performance, keep tessellation disabled, anti-aliasing off, and resolution set to system. If many of your games play in full screen, leave the box ticked. But if you enjoy playing your games in a windowed or borderless mode, uncheck it. Hit the run box and it'll start showing you cinematics. In the top left, hit the benchmarking button or you can press F9. In the top right, you will see an FPS and GPU or graphics processing unit counter. When you start the benchmark, it'll show you everything it is looking for in the bottom right of the screen. If the scenes look choppy, turn down the settings a bit. Let all 26 scenes play through and at the end it'll give you a score. You can save this score if you want to compare later after you finish this series. Now that you know this, we can start the FPS boosting guide. Let's face it, you're watching this video because your computer isn't playing games as well as you'd like it to, so I'm going to fix that. After you finish this series, compare your benchmarks from before and after. Also, there are some things you might want to consider. 60 FPS is equivalent to 60 Hz on TVs and monitors, which means that you can only see a maximum of 60 frames per second because your screen is 60 Hz, regardless of your PC's performance. Likewise, 120 FPS will best be seen on 120Hz TVs and monitors. In some cases, it is possible for a game to look choppy because your monitor can't output the correct number of frames shown per second. Check your monitor specifications and if need be, cap your frame rate in-game to the same number of Hz in your monitor for a smoother view of the game. Also, capping the frame rate can stop your graphics card or processor from overheating. For this series, it is recommended that you create a system restore point just in case you happen to do something incorrectly. To create a system restore, go to the Start menu, right-click Computer, and select Properties. On the left-hand side, click System Protection. At the very bottom of the window, you will see a button to create a system restore point. Click this button, and then you title your restore point to something you will remember. To restore back to this point, on the System Protection tab, there is a button titled System Restore, which you click and then hit Next. Select the restore you'd like to come back to, then follow instructions on how to do so. In the following videos, I will be going over specific programs and tricks to boost your FPS. You can click any of the annotations on screen to view a different part of the series, or click the big box to view the next video.